Hi, my name is Sean. I'm not an attorney, but I work for Joseph C. McDaniel, PC, a debt relief agency that helps both people and businesses file for bankruptcy. Today we discuss the topic, should I use a Chapter 13 to strip down liens in my Arizona bankruptcy? Well, maybe, but I'm not enthusiastic about it. It sounds so easy when you hear about it on television and radio ads for bankruptcy, but it requires a Chapter 13 plan and payments to a Chapter 13 trustee who works very hard and is accordingly paid for his or her trouble, and 3 to 5 long years of payments. And finally, then, if the good Lord is willing and the creek don't rise, you get to scrape off a lien, either in part or entirely. But what happens if Meredith Whitney's predictions are accurate and the consumer real estate market drops like a rock during the 3 years of your plan? And now you're still upside down and underwater and you owe far more than your house is worth. After you've suffered with big payments through your Chapter 13 plan for those 3 to 5 long years, well, that's not so good, is it? And how grateful do you think you'll be to your Arizona bankruptcy attorney who let you make those brutal payments for those long, long years? P.S. Remember, the cost differential between a Chapter 7 and a Chapter 13 is only slightly reflected in the legal fees, which are really trivial in relation to the debts. The real cost advantage of a Chapter 7 bankruptcy shows up when you calculate the amounts you pay to the Chapter 13 trustee and to the unsecured creditors and all the other payments you're making during the life of a Chapter 13 plan. After all, if Chapter 13s were great in every way, we'd still be filing them the way we did back in 1980. We could generate a zero payment Chapter 13 that had a chance of passing muster. And then we could scrape off almost any debts with the super discharge. And yes, in Virginia, that is a word, super discharge. That's not true now. And yes, you should do the math. Thank you.